Hey guys, my name is Malik Wasim and I'm here with André Hammonds of Shop Him. And we're here to interview and talk a little bit about the Shop Him collection and what inspired him to start this brand. So André, tell us a little bit about yourself and your brand and what inspired you.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for having me. As you said, I am the owner of Shop Him, and so I'm a fashion stylist before anything. And being a fashion stylist is kind of what gave me the inspiration to start the brand. Shop Him, at its core, is about heritage. I started it with my best friend only about a year and a half ago. So we're still new, we're still growing, we're still expanding, but Shop Him is very near and dear to my heart.
Oh, that's amazing. It's so good to hear people like following their dreams and things like that. Like, what inspired you? Like, what inspired this collection and how is it a reflection of yourself?
Well, one thing about me is I love what I like to call guy glam. I love to get the glitz and the glam, and I like to feel, you know, dressed up and sparkly and all those good things. And that's what really kind of inspired the collection. We're really big on, as you can see, things that have a little shimmer detail. We love textures, we love print. And we're just about making a statement and doing it through your clothes.
That's amazing. That is amazing. So, like, what... in terms of being a business owner, I know there's a lot of ups and downs that comes along with it. Like, what keeps you motivated and inspired during these ups and downs?
Obviously, being a small business owner during the time of COVID-19 is a challenge, right? It's something that's really, you know, prevalent and prominent. But I think the biggest thing that's kept me inspired is just knowing that the people that I am reaching and that I am connecting with, they see the value in the brand that I'm bringing and what I'm trying to build here. And I think one of the biggest things that you have to remember is that it's a journey and not a race, right? So you can't look at it in terms of like the short term. You want to set short term goals, but they should all serve the grand scheme, the bigger picture of everything. So I would just say stay motivated, keep believing in yourself, keep pushing. There will absolutely be ups and downs, but during those times of downs, just try to remember what motivated you to start your business, what motivated you to, you know, really follow your dreams and see them through.
Yeah, that's amazing, because I know a lot of like small business owners, they get frustrated after like a month or 2 months.
Yeah.
You're doing something and it's not working.
Exactly.
Or you're posting and you're not getting like the traction that you want right away. So you would say like consistency is the key.
Absolutely. Yeah. Consistency, tenacity is the name of any game. You know, like it's kind of like, what is it? The rabbit and the turtle, the hare and the turtle. You know, the turtle won the race, not because he was fast, but because he stayed at it. And I think that that's oftentimes true in a lot of things in life, is that if you see things through the long haul and don't look for instant gratification, yes, it might mean you have to, you know, invest a little more financially in your business. Yes, it might mean you might have to burn the midnight oil. Yes, it might mean that you might have to be vocal and aggressive, but ultimately, if that's what you have to do to create the longevity of your business, you should do it, because it's a service to yourself. It's only a disservice if you don't do it.
Right, that's true. So like, what roadblocks have you faced so far, like in your business overall? Like, what type of things have been thrown in your way and you've overcome them?
I would say marketing was a huge thing that I'm still learning and I'm still growing. Like, as a small business, you don't have, you know, thousands and thousands of dollars to put into marketing and advertising your business. And I think that's one of the key things that helps you to reach your customers, is finding new ways to market and to find unorthodox ways of doing it. You know what I mean? Like, I consider myself my own walking billboard. I know that people subscribe to André because of who André is. So with that being said, if that means that I have to take every piece of clothes out of my inventory and make sure that I have it so that I can wear it and present it, then that's what I have to do. And so marketing was one of the things. Obviously, again, with the whole COVID-19, we were a very physical business. We would do pop-up shops and we would do other face-to-face interactions with our customers. And unfortunately, we did not have that liberty anymore. And so I think it was just about, you know, coming to the board, re-strategizing, thinking of new, fresh ways to connect with the audience. Sometimes it's about going back to the basics, sending out an email blast, creating an Instagram flyer, things that sometimes when you kind of lose those principles, you forget how important and what value they are to your brand and your business.
Wow. That's amazing. So marketing is really important and a lot of brands really struggle with that. So, like, would you say that this is something that you kind of overcame, or are you still on this journey to learn more, or, like, are you still hitting these roadblocks today? Because I know that a lot of times some of our roadblocks might not just automatically go away or go away as fast as we like them to. Mm-hmm. So could you tell us a little bit about how you constantly, you know, stay organized and manage and balance your day-to-day life, like your personal life, with the unpredictableness that comes with having a business?
Oh my gosh, as you have seen firsthand in the few minutes that you've been here, my personal life is very, very hectic. I always have people tugging me and pulling me a million different ways. And then in trying to run a business in that, sometimes I feel like there's just not enough André to go around, child.
Right.
But I think in those moments, again, we have to, A, outsource what we can, you know what I'm saying? Find ways to take some of the load off. And I feel like being a small business owner, sometimes you think, I don't have the resources to do this. You know, do I trust someone to do this? But I think, you know, look within your circle. Maybe you have, you know, a friend that is good with graphic designs, or maybe that person can help you with blasting out emails. I think just looking at, sometimes we have to take a close look at what's in front of us, as opposed to always, you know, maybe thinking out too far. You know what I mean? I think that that's been a service of me, because where I can find help to alleviate some things off of my plate, I do it, I take it, and I just keep going forward.
So prioritizing.
Prioritizing, absolutely. Yeah. Prioritizing is a huge piece of it. Like just knowing what things you need to accomplish, giving yourself milestones. I like to create systems and ways of doing things. And so that way I find that that helps me manage the load. And if I follow, I can tell the difference. Like if I don't do certain systems that I typically do, I can see how it impacts my bottom dollar in terms of the sales and things like that. So like even if it's, hey, I'm going to have a sale this, you know, I'm going to do a sale. I have a list that I follow every time that I have a sale, and I keep myself to that guideline so that I can stay organized, stay productive, and manage it all.
Wow, that's amazing. That is amazing. So thank you for giving us all of these gems and everything. I really want you to like really be successful in your business, and I hope that you see your brand grow to your dreams. And then before we go, I want you to show us your favorite item from Shop Hammonds.
Okay. I'm actually wearing two of my favorite items. I'll tell you that now. The rich silk button-up, okay?
Yes.
And then the Miami Cuban links. Ooh. These are just two simple pieces. Nice. They look so luxury. They look, you know, I feel expensive. Mm-hmm. I feel like it looks expensive.
Stand up. Yeah. Let's see it.
Just give a little
show
for you guys. And then here, one of my other favorites would be the opulent button up. Just, you know,
yes,
I can see like something like this. I can totally see you have a nice body. I can see you under there shining and glistening. And this is my favorite too. I told y'all I like a sparkle. The Icon Bomber Jacket. And the Icon Bomber Jacket is just the quality, feel the weight of it.
Yes,
it's really, really nice. I try to keep all of my items as close to around the $100 price point as possible. Mm-hmm. So like this jacket would be like $119. But if you sign up with my new customer discount, you save 15%. And if you spend $100, you get free shipping. So visit shop-hem.com. And that's hem spelled H-E-M, like the hem of a garment. And check us out.
Thank you so much, André. And I will see you guys soon. Let me know what you think, how you feel about André and Shop Him. Let me know in the comments. Thank you guys. Bye.